Hey, what's up, you guys? It is Troy Sivan, and every now and then I do this little thing called Ask Troy. First of all, sorry if I talk weird. I have a mouth ulcer on my tongue, and I feel like my tongue is like really, really fat and I'm poking out. Today I thought I would do an Ask Troy with a twist because I'm wearing a t-shirt, and that t-shirt says Muzak. So today I thought I'd ask you guys sending questions using a hashtag, or the math bit slowing. Hashtag Ask Troy Music. Insert that gif of Tyler Oakley going, "We get it, you're famous."
We get it, you're famous.
Deal with it, Oakley and everyone else who's about to say that. What do you actually say when it sounds like too long to like in your hands? What are the correct lyrics to that in my hands part? Drown or there is one lyric on Wild where I say too long to like drown in your hand, but apparently it sounds like a very different thing. Embarrassingly enough, the first person to ask me this question was actually my mum. She was like, "Love the music, Toki, really, really proud of you, but what is that?" What was your inspiration for Ease? For Ease, the song that I wrote with Broods, I was just kind of picturing, I tweeted this the other day, like laying on my bed and either my mum or one of my friends like tickling my arm like this and saying to me, "You know what, Troy, calm down, everything's gonna be okay. Think about oceans, think about puppies, tell me all of the things that make you feel at ease." And I was like, Doritos, donuts, pizza. The first verse is actually a conversation with my mum on the phone. My mum's biggest worry whenever I travel is, "Troy, are you eating? Are you taking care of yourself?" And so the opening lyric is, "Now I'm down to my skin and bones." It was kind of about that moment where you're alone without your mum and everything kind of feels like it's falling to shit. And then the second verse in the song is a similar conversation, but this time it's with your baby, with your boy. It's like that moment where you're like, to be honest, I am down to my skin and bones, and to be honest, everything's kind of f***ed at the moment, and I miss you, and I love you, and I wish I was back at home with you tickling my arm. Yeah. Kind of a sad song. I don't want to talk about it anymore. Use all of the names of your album in a sentence. Wow, what a wild question you've just asked me. A fool would be able to do this. If it will put you at ease, I will do it. I will not stay the quiet about it and do it for you. DKLA. Tell Me Fools is your next single, please. I said this in a live stream the other day, but indeed, Fools is the next music video in the Blue Neighborhood trilogy. Is Fools about chasing after someone who's straight? It's about unrequited love, which is obviously a common theme in people's lives. It's when you love someone and they don't love you back. And so the verses are sort of about that, but then the chorus, I kind of just thought to myself, I'm like, Troy, you're away all the time, you know, talking about touring one day and stuff like that, and thinking about how much I was traveling and blah blah blah. It was this really poor me moment of only a fool would fall for me, basically. I'm in a much happier place than when I wrote Fools, by the way. By the way, this video is actually sponsored by Audible. Audible.com is the leading provider of audiobooks with over 180,000 titles. I just finished listening to Life or Death by Michael Robotham. If you use my link audible.com/Troy, you get your first book free when you sign up. That's audible.com/Troy. Hope you guys like it. Listen to books. Was there any lyrics that had people go, "What the f*** is that about? Holy shit, giggles." Definitely the drown in your hands line, apparently. What happened to that recording from Playlist? Basically, if you guys didn't know it, Playlist Live in New York, I asked you guys to shout back some stuff back to me, and so I got you to shout out, "Only Fools," and that is actually in Fools. At the very, very end of Fools, if you listen, you can hear all of your beautiful voices. You sound amazing. Thank you for being on my album and for duetting with me. I can't think of anyone else that I would rather have on there. Describe the feeling that you wanted each song to give off. I'm gonna attempt to do this without using words. Wild. Bite. Fools. Ease. The quiet. And finally, DKLA. That's me stomping on my heart. Ow, that hurt my foot. "Kiss me on the mouth and set me free, but please don't bite." What is the meaning of that lyric? Bite is about my first time in a gay club, and you know, I was excited. I was like, "What's up? You are sweaty and shirtless." But at the same time, I was also very much like, I feel like a tiny little kid in this club. Like, I was freshly 18, and I just felt like everyone was so much bigger than me. And so I think it was about kind of like, yes, make this dream of me coming to a place where everyone is either LGBT or at least accepting of LGBT people, and I can finally just like walk up to someone and kiss them, like I've seen all of my friends do since we were 14. But at the same time, I wanted to kind of show that vulnerability that I felt. There's like a little bit of innocence, kind of like a lullaby, but at the same time, there's like really dark, like kind of chaos to it. Music talk, hell yeah! And finally, what song are you most excited to perform on your tour? If you don't know, I announced that I'm gonna be going on tour starting in the US in October. I'm really excited to play Wild live. Wild is very, very, very fun to sing live. I just can't wait. But yeah, that is it for this week's video, you guys. I hope you liked it. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you all very, very soon. Love you. Bye.